But what about the course that's waiting for them out on the water? Shirley, talk us through it.
It's going to be a tough start with a tide pushing them over up to the top mark, back down through the gate, a long run, back up, a long run, back to the finish, and a dash to the finish line.
Plenty of twists and turns, and with that tide as well, plenty of opportunities to get things wrong and right. So to help us try and unpack everything that we're going to be seeing on the water, we have got an Olympian here with us, finishing sixth in the Ilka 6 back in Tokyo, Sarah Douglas from Canada. So Sarah, here we go, 1 minute 30 to go, and five of our sailors could be finishing on that top spot on the podium.
Yes, and it's the lightest wind we've seen all week. We've been hiking every day, so this is going to be a very interesting race to see how the leaderboard could change with the light wind today.
Anne-Marie Rindom from Denmark in the blue. She's going to be pushing pretty hard to try and find a way through here. It's all really going to come down to who beats who. In the red, Maria Erdi from Hungary, standing up at the moment, trying to make that last-minute decision as to the best way to go. There we can see Rindom from Denmark. Everybody looking forward, judging that attack to the line. 45 seconds to go. We're already quite close at the moment, and the tide is still sweeping us over the line. Marriott Baumeister, also in contention, sitting in fourth at the moment, could climb into that gold medal position, close to the committee boat, into the pack at the moment. We are getting close to this line by the committee boat. Going to be difficult to see how we can get some space here right next to the line. It is from the Netherlands. Marriott Baumeister just going past the committee boat. We've got the final few seconds to go, and we are dangerously close to seeing the Dutch sailor over the line. The last few seconds go, and it was very close there. I think someone was over the line. We're going to have to wait and see exactly. A few of the sailors looping back round to try and clear. So far, clear at the moment. So it seems like people that were too close to the line managed to loop themselves around and come back through. That was Denmark's Anne-Marie Rindom and the Australian competitor, Mara Stratsky. They are now off, and it is light, and it is very difficult to keep the speed up.
You can just see how they're struggling to get through the waves as well, and they're just really, really trying to squeeze the boat as much as you can to get through those waves and get a little bit of speed out from the really light racing you have.
And we saw the Ilka 7s, the men's, just a little while ago. They were sailing in conditions. I think it's gone a little bit light, but now we've got a penalty going on the water here. I think we can learn a little bit more about that now. Well, we were just waiting to hear from the umpires, but they're obviously a little bit busy just dishing out that penalty. So we'll have to wait to find out exactly who that penalty was. There were some spins on the line, and it looked like it was the Denmark sailor, Anne-Marie Rindom, the Olympic medalist from Tokyo. So unfortunately, she is on the back foot right now. She comes into this with the blue bib. She was started in second place. So she's going to have to work hard to recover. And she is heading out to the left-hand side in the red. Maria Erdi from Hungary being forced to bounce from left to right. And Jaye from Switzerland in the yellow also tacking out. There's a lot of tacks in the middle here. No one can find a lane.
When it's really light wind like this, tacking actually, you can gain quite a bit of speed out of them. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's quite a lot of tacks in this race. Just try to squeeze every little bit of speed out of every maneuver.
Now, you say that as a competitor, but I got to say, don't say that to the judges, because you do not gain speed out of your tacks. You conserve speed. And I'm sure that that is what you meant. And I'm sure that that is what our sailors are trying to do on the water. But we have got a situation here where in the red, Maria Erdi from Hungary is locking down the Swiss sailor, Maud Jaye, absolutely closing her down here, trying to stay with her the whole way. No clear leader at the moment. As Marriott Baumeister from the Netherlands coming in from the right-hand side.
Both these sailors not really used to being in this position. It's a real changing of the guard at this World Championships. Obviously, Marie Rindon from Denmark was a gold medalist in Tokyo. She's used to the stress and the pressure. But for Jaert and for Erdi, this is all new.
Josephine Olsen from Sweden. Second at the Olympics in Tokyo. Silver medal. Trying here for the best result she can, which will be, by my math, certainly a sixth. She's currently in seventh place on the overall. The race really for the gold between Jaye Rindom, Erdi Baumeister and Rose from the United States. And as things lie right now, Maud Jaye from Switzerland is doing just enough. But really, we're not going to get a clear view of that until we get to the top of the course and we get round mark one. There is, in the yellow bib, Maud Jaye from Switzerland. So much work, not wanting to have your weight in the wrong position just for a moment.
She has really attacked this quad. I mean, she was a sailor 3 years ago who always finished 16th. And now look at her, working harder than ever. They have a new coach, Mikael Lundell, really just raised the intensity. Even on the days off this week, they were in the gym, they were training, they were just keeping the focus when it would easily, well, it'd be easy to let that fall away.
She's going to have to work incredibly hard here. That was a bit of a tricky tack, and she's going to have to work hard because right now she is the furthest, the closest towards the shore side of the race course, and she is down the field at the moment. There you can see with the Swiss flag on the top of your screen. She's got a lot of the other boats in front of her as we just adjust the position for Emma Plasma-Chirp from Belgium, just coming in here in second place, just behind Josephine Olsen from Sweden.
It's been a really long week for the Ilka Sixes. You know, we've used every single reserve day. And so for the competitors today, it's their eighth day in a row. So I know that they're feeling tired, but they really want to push through this race and hopefully be on top of the leaderboard for some of them.
Now, we have seen boats getting these ley lines wrong. And at the moment, no one wanting to have been over that ley line. And the whole fleet has lined up underneath it. So in the lead from Sweden, Josephine Olsen, silver medalist, doing the two tacks to then get herself round the mark. Behind, we can see the yellow bib of Maud Jaye, hoping to hold on to that top spot. Has she been able to get that ley line a little bit better here? There should be a little bit of current helping her up. I think it's just good enough to come round. She's got just ahead of her Emma Plasma-Chirp from Belgium, and then just sneaking in on the inside as well. Other sailors coming through. Sweden now coming round, sailing low out of that mark. Switzerland getting very low now, and it's tight at the top of the course. Charlotte Rose of the United States, Mara Stransky from Australia at the back of the moment, but in the blue, Anne-Marie Rindom from Denmark all the way behind. She came into this medal race in second place. Unfortunately for her, she had that penalty to do on the line. For what, we're not too sure, but you could argue probably it was for something like illegal kinetics, for a little bit of pumping. And she has now got a mountain to climb as we go onto the downwind leg.
We've also got quite a long downwind now as well, just fighting the tide. Just like we saw in the Laser Men, it'll kind of spread out, looking for the most wind and seeing if they can kind of get that breeze towards the mark and really see if they can make some advances on the group.
Well, still in the lead at the moment, it is Josephine Olsen from Sweden, but she cannot climb any higher than sixth place overall if things go her way. So it's really about what happens with the other riders and what they make of this condition. Let's hear from Lily on the water at the moment as to what might make the difference on this run.
Yeah, the wind has dropped to a little bit, but at the same time, we probably have half of the current speed compared with the Ilka Seven Men's. So it's still quite challenging sailing in this condition. And then normally when we sail light wing, we're sailing by the lee if the water is pretty flat. But because the current now is against the wind, creating those extra bumpy, wavy condition. So you can see sailors trying to sail in a broad reach because that is easier to control in this type of condition. Yeah, it would be interesting to see and we'll sail a better downwind in the end.
Well, we're certainly seeing that here, a real fanning out of the fleet at the moment. There you can see from Belgium, Emma Plasma-Chirp. She won the Worlds back in 2021, and she's going to have to work pretty hard to hold on to sixth or at least climb to fifth. That's the highest that she can be once this medal race is finished.
Matt Wearne's wife, she would have looked on with pride about an hour ago. But interestingly, some of the big players in this fleet have not really delivered, including her. She'll be frustrated with her performance. Came into today in sixth, was expecting more. Marit Baumeister from the Netherlands has won everything this year and just not delivered on her in our hometown.
We've had a little bit of a reshuffling of the pack here, and Maria Erdi from Hungary, who we are on board with now, she is currently sitting strong enough. She has overtaken some boats, and she is currently sitting in a position where she will be on the top spot of the podium. She's in third place at the moment. Just in front of her is Emma Plascher from Belgium. There you can see it on the tracker, with Baumeister from the Netherlands behind in fourth. And this just goes to show you how close things are on the scores. A few place changes and suddenly we have a very different look on the podium.
And you can just see how light it is as well. Like, they're really struggling to fill their sails. The main sheet's kind of dropping down. That's why they're going from by the lead to kind of broad reach. Just try to keep the sail as full as possible and try and get as much speed because it's just so light.
And the danger with that is that you get tempted to pump. And that looks like that's what's happened to the Swiss sailor here. Maud Jaillet has had to do a penalty turn on the water. And that is why we are seeing that change on the water. Let's hear from the umpire and see if we can get a little bit of an idea just as to what happened there on the water.
The umpire has penalized Switzerland for rocking.
There we go, for rocking, pumping, ooching, all of these things that we're not allowed to do when we're out on the racetrack, unless we are let off the leash. But for these conditions, it needs to be about how you adjust your sail to the wind rather than generating it yourself by simply fanning the sail. So we're all a bit tempted. We all push things to the limit. And sadly, the umpire's deciding that it was a little bit over. Charlotte Rose from the United States taking a nice wide route and pushing wise. Anne-Marie Rindom from Denmark, who is still trying to find her way through. Can Rindom get on the inside line of that mark? And she can't. Charlotte Rose from the United States denying the charge there from the gold medalist and pushing her still, or at least holding her back there in the yellow bib. Maud Jaillet from Switzerland heading out to the right-hand side. That penalty turn now done, but she is right back at the moment in seventh place, and she's going to have to work very hard from there.
Taking a bit of a split from the rest of the fleet, probably hoping for some sort of right shift or right pressure. Maybe a little bit of risk, but, you know, she's not got a lot to lose here.
She doesn't need to work too hard. She doesn't need to overtake too many boats to get back into it. There you can see the predictive standings. It is still with Hungary at the top at the moment. But Jaillet from Switzerland in second. See, look how tight those points are as well. Baumeister from the Netherlands will be taking bronze. But everything could change on the next shift.
Maria Erdal, who's leading now. She's only 25, but she's been to two Olympic Games, Rio and Tokyo, 14th and 13th. What a mature performance, though. Keeping our head together when our heart is racing, not pumping too much on that run when, you know, all you want to do is just try and just get a couple more inches ahead of the opposition. An incredibly mature performance so far from the Hungarian.
Well, they're all going to be looking for what they can find on the water. We are about halfway up this final upwind leg before that last downwind. So let's go to Rick in the helicopter and see where the gains might be on the course.
Yeah, hi, Niall. What I'm doing right now, I'm not actually watching the Ilka boats. I'm actually looking at some of the bigger boats, the spectator boats and the committee boats that are down at the leeward end. And I'm starting to see them all hanging off their anchor at different angles, which is telling me that there really isn't that much tide right now. And at the same time, I'm seeing the flags hanging limp. So I think the wind is really, really dying. So these sailors are going to really start having to work the boats harder and harder and harder.
We've seen some tacking. We're seeing some work in that sense, trying to find the best of the breeze, certainly trying to find a route up to the top of the course. That is the action here from the Hungarian sailor, Erdi. At the moment, doing enough, if things stay as they are, to be wearing the gold medal when this race is completed. On top of her, Josefine Olsen from Sweden, but with the points the way they are for Sweden, it's not going to be any better than potentially a sixth in the final scores. And there is Josefine Olsen coming in from the right-hand side of our screen, and it's starting to show how light it is.
And Josephine's got so much experience as well. You know, she's been to three Olympics. She's targeting her fourth. She got a silver medal. I mean, her dominance and just success in the ILCA 6 really paying off, and here she's showing off in this race.
And she's taken the opportunity in that final approach to the windward mark to do a few more tacks as well. It goes to show how shifty it is and how hungry they are for the gains.
Exactly. She's just kind of putting herself in that position to kind of lose cover of the fleet. She's going over to Emma Plaschert on the left-hand side and make sure that she's kind of got her covered and making sure she's got a final approach to the top mark.
She's done well here. She's sitting on top of Plaschert from Belgium, just out of view on that left-hand side. There's the Hungarian sailor with the red bib on, trying to find a way through. Erdi going to be able to use Josefine Olsen from Sweden to judge that ley line. Also there in the blue bib, Rindum from Denmark coming in just out of shot on the left-hand side. Let's see what happens when we come through here. I don't think Anne-Marie Rindum is going to have a clean run into this mark. There's still a lot of boats between her and the buoy that are going to be coming in from out of shot on the right-hand side. Emma Plaschert from Belgium, the world number two. Fourth in the last Olympics. Second on the water here. Red is coming up here. Erdi from Hungary. This is good. This will start to make things a little bit more certain. She is leading the field of contenders for that gold medal. Erdi from Hungary, now around the top of the course, sitting in the gold medal position. Behind her, another gold medal contender, Bouwmeester from the Netherlands. And then the Portuguese sailor, Caracalu, out of the gold medal contention. So we're going to see Bouwmeester and Erdi, and of course they split. Marit Bouwmeester from the Netherlands in the middle of our screens, trying to find a way through. The next to come through in the blue bib, Anne-Marie Rindum from Denmark, the reigning Olympic champion, opting to head close to the shore. In the yellow bib, Moore Jaye from Switzerland, the world number four, trying to find a way back through after that penalty.
And dealing with a main sheet knot there as well, as you can see from the top mark.
So the main sheet coming off at the back. So this is probably maybe a mechanical failure, maybe just simply a knot coming undone, but something going wrong on her boom there. She's going to have to adjust her sailing style. That is not what you want when you're on the back foot on a final run in a medal race. So she is pushing her way down right now, trying to get herself through the field. Everybody very spread out at the moment. In the red from Hungary, Maria Erdi, sitting at the moment on the water in third place. But on the overall scores in that gold medal position, she's got right behind her Portuguese sailor, Vasília Caracalu, right behind her, ninth of the last Olympic Games. She can't go all the way through, but she is really pushing hard. Now, we've seen an awful lot of penalties out on the water at the moment. And I think we get a little bit of a chance to have a look back and see that penalty. This was the moment that we had for rocking, for generating a little bit of power just with the body movements. And that was the penalty turn here by Moore Jaye from Switzerland. One turn penalty, attack and a jibe completed, and a little bit of a stall on the way out. And that's why she lost so many places. But she's in the hunt now. And for the moment, she's sitting in about seventh place, trying to find a way down. But there is precious few moments left in this race. Predicted scores at the moment, and it is with Erdi from Hungary. Jaye from Switzerland will be in second place, and Bouwmeester from the Netherlands in third. Josefine Olsen from Sweden, sailing well, but ultimately out of contention for the medals. There you can see in the red, Erdi from Hungary. That's the sailor that's doing the right things at the right time in this race.
She's got to be careful because that jury has that Hawkeye. But it is super, super light. You can just see the sailors continuing to look back, being like, where is the wind, and finding the most pressure.
And you want to be on the limit. I mean, you want to take it. There are certain things you're allowed to do. You want to be able to go all the way there. But, of course, you don't want to be going over that line. And that is why we're seeing everybody being very careful here. pushing down towards that gate. Let's go to Lily out on the water to get her perspective as to how that race is shaping up. Oh, we're going to come back here because we're going to stay with the action as we get down to this mark. You can see the work rate here of Erdi from Hungary, pushing that boat down on every wave. Every wave needing that little bit of adjustment. Josephine Olsen from Sweden, safely out in front. Emma Plasmacher from Belgium coming through on that left-hand side. Josephine Olsen here, showing everybody else just how light and how slow they are going to be by the time they get to that mark and they need to run deep in order to round. There's that last turning mark, but this is the battle behind at the moment. In the red bib from Hungary, Maria Erdi on that left-hand side. This is the battle here for the gold medal. Emma Plasmacher from Belgium, she can't climb higher than fifth. Having her in front of the Hungarian sailor is not a damage to Maria Erdi's race for the gold. Portugal also coming in, but it's the Netherlands sailor. That's the real risk. Marit Bouwmeester trying to come through. She's already got three Olympic medals as Josephine Olsen from Sweden now comes through the finish line. Hungary coming down. Erdi pushing at the moment, still in that gold medal position. Ahead of her, out of view, she has got Belgium. There is Emma Plasschaert coming across the line in second place. But that's not going to matter. Hungary holds on and Maria Erdi takes the top spot, the pointer on her side. The question will be how quick is her maths, but she has done enough. Now she knows there is the fist in the air. Maria Erdi from Hungary, the world number 11, is now world champion. Now behind from Denmark, Anne-Marie Rindom, coming into this medal race, wearing the blue bib, coming in second place in that silver medal position. She comes across the line and it looks like she's going to slip down into the bronze position. Moore Jaye from Switzerland finishing just behind her in the yellow as we go on board now. She will take silver. Charlotte Rose from the United States next to come through. And then Albo from Italy. And that rounds out our 10 Ilka Sixes coming through. So it really did come down to that final run and that last little chance on board at the moment with Maud Jaye. Be disappointed, but ultimately still a medal. Silver this time around.
She did well, Niall, to recover from that turn. It wasn't looking good for a while and she kept her head, sailed fast and just picked her way back through the fleet. But for this young woman from Hungary, if you're watching this in Hungary, stand up. Give her a big cheer. She has. This is her first big senior victory. This means the world.
And looks like we're going to be able to hear from the top sailors. Anne-Marie Rindom from Denmark. She will be taking that bronze medal. And Anne-Marie Rindom, in terms of the sailors that are going to be on that podium, she's the one with the most silverware, with the most titles. But we've had two new, fresh, young sailors taking the spots just above her. But we can hear now from our new world champion.
Mary, now world champion. I saw your tears. How do you feel now?
It's been such a stressful week. And yeah, I was there the whole week, but I was nervous about today's race, wondering if I could finish it off. And it was light winds, and we worked a lot on my lighter speed with my coach in the past year, and I was confident going into the race, but it was really tricky, very shifty, and people coming at me from every direction, so I was just trying to focus on my speed, and luckily I could get away, but it's really, I cannot believe it, and
Yeah. And you said you had so much pressure and then feeling very nervous. How you conquered this and still performed so well?
Well, as soon as we got out here and I saw the conditions, I was quite confident in my speed. But of course, you know, so many things can go wrong here. And I think I was quite close to the line at the start. So when I finished, I just wanted to wait and see if it's real and just
so happy, and I hope everybody at home is watching, and I'm sending everyone a big hug.
Any words to your home fans, followers, family and friends?
Well, I just just want to say thanks to everyone, and thanks to the people who never gave up on me, because in the last couple of years, there were moments where I started to give up on myself, but I feel like last summer, my coach and I started doing very good work, and it started to show throughout the year. But to come away with a world championship title, I never wanted to like say it, because it's just so amazing. Like, it's coming true, and yeah, I have no words. Just very, very happy.
So enjoy your day. And 2023 Ilka 6 world champion Maria Erdi from Hungary.
Well, that's quite an emotional moment, and it's not difficult to understand why. She had already been to two Olympic Games, and she'd never been able to get higher than 13th. Now she gets a world championship title, and if you weren't cheering for her before, you'll be happy seeing how much it means to her.
Sarah and I have a tear in her eye. I mean, what a lovely response. You get a real sense of what it means, how hard she's worked for it, and just how much this moment means to her and all the people who work with her and all the people who've believed that in the end it would come good.
And it's been just such an emotional roller coaster for the whole week. You know, yesterday after the last race, she came to me and said, you know, that race might have been the worst of my career. And now look at her today, being a world champion, celebrating with her coach. Just such an emotional thing as an athlete. This is something you've worked for your entire life, and now she gets to celebrate here with her coach in Holland.
Fascinating to hear her say how much work that they had done on their light wind sailing, and the fact that came into play today. And you know, there are a million things to work on. There are a million skills. The list is endless. But that one, they got razor sharp, and well, didn't it pay? Well, let's have a confirmation of the overall result for the women's dinghy, the Ilka 6. Maria Erdi from Hungary, now world champion. Morjai from Switzerland will take the silver medal, and Anne-Marie Rindom from Denmark will take the bronze.